Hey everyone, Matt here from SoundSwitch. In this tutorial video, we're going to be explaining the Auto Loops feature. So let's get into it. So in this video, we're going to explain the Auto Loops feature and how it works. We'll show you edit mode for creating and customizing the default Auto Loops that are shipped with the software. And then we'll switch to performance mode and show you how they work when connected to your DJ performance system. There's a common misconception that with SoundSwitch, you need to manually create a light show for every song in your DJ set, but that's not true. You can use the auto scripting feature, which will automatically create a light show for a specific song, or you can use the auto loops feature, which are created separate from audio files, but load and sync for all the tracks that you play back. For example, if you load a song on the right deck that is auto-scripted or has a custom show created, the light show or the auto-script will automatically play back. If you play a song that has no light show created at all, the auto loops will automatically load and play back for you. So the first thing we're going to do is jump over into edit mode and show you how the auto loops are created and how you can customize the default ones that come shipped with SoundSwitch. We'll start by opening edit mode. I'll start by selecting the Gigbar Move venue that's been set up, and then I will select the A for the auto loop feature. I can then open any of the auto loops, and I'll open one from the Chill Bank. Here I'll press play, and I can see that the lights are pulsing in a slow chill intensity effect, and my colors are changing from red to blue. I also have some gobo effects and some effects on my derbies. So what happens if I want to change the color of this auto loop? I can right click on the color section and edit the color region, and I'm going to change it from green to blue. I can select in the main track and add an intensity effect. Double click on the pulse effect. I'll bring this down to 50%, and I will select to add the effect every one bar. If I want to change the color of one of my movers, I can select that track, right click and select apply color, and I'll make it green for the entire track. And on my other mover down the bottom here, I will make a selection, right click and apply the same green color. I can now see that I have green on my movers, and I have a slow pulsing effect at 50%. Awesome. So what do the other auto loops look like? I'll open one from the dance bank and press play. So here we can see that my lights are chasing, there's a lot more energy, and these effects in bank one are more high energy than they are in the chill bank in bank four. If I open the first auto loop in bank two and press play, you can see that there's a number of different effects again. These have all been pre-designed for you, and if you have the Gigbar Move, there's also effects placed in the fixture tracks. If you're setting up your own venue, you'll need to customize those fixture tracks to have things such as chases or color changes. If I open one of my chill auto loops, I can make a selection here in my group track, and I can find a chase effect, and I'll add a forward chase, and I will apply it to my group. I'll have it pulse every quarter beat, and if I press play, you can now see that my lights are chasing. If you would like to create a new auto loop, simply right click on any of the auto loops and delete it, then press the plus icon to create a new one and choose the duration. Here I'm going to choose 32 bars. Now we have a totally blank auto loop. The best thing to start with is a few colors, so we'll right click and apply a color transition from blue, press spacebar to change to the end, and press red. Then I will lift up my intensity, and if I press play, you can see that not a lot's happening. The intensity is staying still, and the color is slowly changing from blue to red. If I want to speed up that color change, I just simply drag that effect. Then I can make a selection, press press Command or Control C, and then make a selection and press Paste, or set the playhead and press Paste as well. So now I have 9 bar color changes, and I want to add in some intensity effects. So here I will select the intensity, and I'll double click on a smooth pulse, and I'll set that at 100% and have the effect applied every bar. Perfect, that's cool. Then I'll have my intensity stay still for a bit. And then during this section, I will have a flash pulse every half bar. Perfect. And then at the end, I'll lift up my intensity and I will make this flat here as well. Perfect. Now I will make a selection on one of my movers. I'll right click and I'll apply a red color. I'll scroll down, select the right mover and apply red as well. And then I want to add a few movement effects. So I'll select in the movement track, right click and apply a movement effect. I'll do a figure eight and I will have the speed increase over time. And then I'll add some gobo change cues. I'll open that cue up, change the gobo to something I like. Perfect. And then I'll add another cue here and I'll add one more towards the end. And then I'll add some position cues. These are for my pan and tilt settings. So if you get started with SoundSwitch and you find that your movers aren't moving, just remember you have to set the pan and tilt settings in the position cues. Double click, select the lights you want to move, and move them around the room. Once they're in position, you can change to the next one. You can move these around as well. I'll do the same thing for the right. Once I press apply, all of the cues that I've placed in the main track will automatically update with those new positions. So if I press play, I can see that I've got some color transitions on my pars, and I've got some movement as well as some gobos and some different colors on my movers. I'm pretty happy with that. I can go through and change the name of the bank or name the auto loop something different by simply right clicking and selecting to rename. And I'm going to call this blue to red. Perfect. If you would like to change the name of the bank, you can double click to select the name and we will call this relaxed lights. Perfect. Now that we have everything set up in edit mode and we've customized one of our auto loops and we've made a new one, let's switch over to performance mode and show you how this connects with our DJ software. Now remember, we haven't auto scripted any of these tracks or created custom light shows for them. The one key thing to remember is that we have accurate beat grids set in our DJ software. This is because the grid that you see in SoundSwitch will automatically sync with the grid in your DJ software. So if your grid is off or out in your DJ software, your light show is going to be a little bit off as well. Let's switch over to performance mode and see how our light shows look. I will open performance mode and select my gig bar move menu. And then I will press play. Perfect. My auto loops are starting to play back. But how do I play back the auto loop that I designed? Well, in the performance mode controls, we'll switch to the auto loop screen and then we'll select our blue to red auto loop. And as you can see now, it's playing back the auto loop that I created earlier in edit mode. If I want to play one of the other auto loops, I'll select my smooth pulse auto loop from my dance bank and you'll be able to see that my light shows are now playing back. It's in time and there's new chases across my lights. Let's select something from the hip hop bank, which is a little bit more chill, but still in time with the music. And I might switch to just using my relaxed lighting bank. So now only my auto loops in that bank will play back. I can also choose to select the next auto loop or the previous auto loop, which will allow me to choose whether I want to move forward or back in the auto loop play order. And I can also choose to repeat the currently playing auto loop. Now, by selecting this, it will repeat the auto loop that is currently being played back, and it will continue to play back until the end of the audio file. I can also choose to override all my scripted tracks with auto loops only, but I only really want to do that if I'm sure my auto loops are what I want. If you have scripted tracks and you want those to play back, make sure that this setting is not selected. At the bottom of the screen, I can also choose to play back the auto loops sequentially or at random. And if I want to go back to playing all banks, I can simply select play all banks. And now SoundSwitch will randomize the playback of all of those auto loops. If you have created a bank of auto loops and you do not want these to automatically play back with the songs in performance mode, you can disable the autoplay option by selecting this checkbox. When this is unchecked, the auto loops in this bank will not play back automatically. This is helpful if you've created a bank of auto loops that are specific for a drop or a particular effect. Let's say you have an auto loop that has a lot of strobing effects and you don't want this to play back randomly during the middle of a song. Unchecking this box will mean that these auto loops in this bank will not play back automatically. If you need help with auto loops or you have any questions, please reach out in the comment section below or send an email to support@soundswitch.com. You can also join the Facebook group or send us a message on Instagram or Facebook Messenger. Thank you, and we look forward to seeing you in another video.